Train the muscles, not the joints.
So welcome back to Natural Glam Bodybuilding. And today I'm gonna answer a question that's always asked me. People are always asking me, what supplements do I use? And I did a video about this about 2 or 3 years ago. And I talk about it sometimes, but I don't really use supplements that often. That's the truth. I don't really use supplements. Sometimes I use a little bit of branched chain amino acids and all that when I go to the gym. But really what I'm gonna be doing is an experiment this next little while, okay? Because really I have been off protein powder. I haven't really been drinking protein powder at all. I've been just eating chicken and steak. But sometimes I find that when I go to the gym, sometimes I haven't eaten enough. I need to eat more and stuff. And I know that if I replace some of my coffee intake,
let's go work out. Hey?
Yeah. Or water intake or whatever it is with a little bit of protein powder, perhaps it'll have an effect on my recovery. And I know in the past it has, but I'm just gonna do an experiment right now and see, okay, what's happening with my body right now. So I am using the Kaizen protein powder right now, and it's sweetened with stevia, and it's grass-fed, okay? And it's supposed to be free of preservatives, and it's a whey isolate. And I know that there's arguments for casein and all this kind of stuff, but this is what I'm gonna be using right now. And I'm gonna be actually supplementing 50 to 100 grams of extra protein a day from this source and see how my energy is in the gym. So in the next few months, if you notice that my gains are going up or something like that, it's probably because my protein is going up and because it's readily available from the protein powder, there's a chance that it may be affecting my recovery, okay? So I'm gonna conduct this experiment for you guys. I'm gonna put the link down below to the protein powder if you wanna buy some, okay? I'll have an Amazon affiliate link. So if you do buy some, a little bit of that money will go to support this channel. But I like the flavor of this stuff, and I like the fact that there's no unnatural crap in it, no chemicals or anything, because that's the thing. I don't want sucralose or aspartame or any of that kind of stuff in my protein powder. And I feel a lot better with more of a natural source. And I like the grass-fed part because I know with grass-fed beef, like I've talked to you guys about before, grass-fed feels totally different than the standard cow, okay? So when I have steak that is normal fed, and then I have steak that's grass-fed, totally different experience of how it feels in my stomach, totally different experience of how I feel when I digest it. So I'm gonna go with this on the whey proteins. Now, the thing is with whey protein, it's not like it's gonna magically change your life or anything, but sometimes it does make it possible for you to have some protein when you don't have food accessible. That's the nice part about a protein shake. So on the live chat the other day, somebody had asked me, what do? They can only eat 3 times a day. How do they basically make sure they get in enough protein and they're eating properly and all that kind of stuff? So if they are in a position where they can still have access to a drink, that will allow them to take in some protein during those times. So yeah, if you want to get a good protein shake, I would say get something that's naturally sweetened with stevia. You know, that's the best substance, I think, right now to sweeten a shake, if you're gonna sweeten one, unless you want just a neutral flavor, no flavor at all. And second of all, grass-fed whey, I think, would be better, just because there's a lot less crap in grass-fed. And I do find that the shakes that I'm drinking right now, some shakes I've gotten a nauseated feeling in my gut from, but these ones, that doesn't happen. And I've noticed it with a few other people that also have the same sort of result when they drink whey protein. And when they drink the grass-fed protein shake, they are not getting the same reaction to it. So yeah, try it out. And thanks a lot for watching, and I hope this helps you out. And I'll put the link down below of the protein that I'm using. If I can access it on Amazon, I might just be able to access the company. Maybe you'll need to do a little research and try and find the grass-fed stuff there if you can, by going to the company's website or something like that. But anyway, I hope this helps you out, and thanks a lot for watching, and take care for now.
Share my stuff.